praise the Lord, everybody. I said, praise the Lord, everybody. It looks like we got a few folks that took their nap too long this afternoon after this morning service, but that's all right. We had a wonderful move of God in the 10 a.m. service and lasted almost one around here. We just had a great, great move of God, and we're looking for and anticipating a great move of God on tonight. Amen. I want to ask our dear assistant bishop all the way from Hayti, Missouri, to come greet us tonight. Take us to the Lord in prayer. Open our service up. Bishop Boswell, you please make him welcome as he comes tonight. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We are so excited about being the children of the Most High God. Hallelujah. I know. Listen, excuse me. I don't mean it up there. He is depending upon you. You made him to get this word out to the world. And he has supplied everything. And I'm holding up. I can't help it. Glory. He's so wonderful. He's all right. Yeah, please, excuse me. But I tell my people sometime, I said, when I come up in church. And I said, a lot of things we heard about God was God. Huh? I heard you this morning talking about that big fella sitting on the throne up there with that lightning bolt waiting to strike it. We heard that type of a thing coming up here. That's not my father. That's not your father.
Right.
Hallelujah. God bless all of you. You're so proud. Listen.
Ah! Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. He that has here, let him do it. The last, one of the last things that Jesus said on the cross, it is finished.
All right.
He come down here to redeem us back to the Father.
Oh, yes.
He had, you know the story. He had to pay the price for your sin, my sin. That sin is done. You're a new creation in Christ. When your righteousness is in Christ and God, there's no weapon that's firm against you, going to prosper. Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you. Thank you for being a father, being a friend, being everything we need. Thank you that you have made the provision in your son Jesus.
Yes.
We welcome you in this place here tonight. Know that without you we can do nothing, with you we can do all things. We ask you to anoint the lips that's going to bring that message, anoint the ears that's going to hear and receive it, anoint God those, that heart that's going to receive that message, the leg that's going to take it to the world. We thank you right now.
Oh,
yes. We are the children of the Most High God. We take back everything that devil has stolen from us. We pray that I speak your blessing over your people here today. God, the word said, bless unto you this. This is the day that the Lord has made. Jesus, when you ascended back into heaven, went into the most holy place with your blood and our high priest erupted us, sprinkle your blood on the mercy seat, sat down at the feet right side of the Father, and send your spirit into our hearts. Give us the right to call y'all. We thank you. We welcome you, God. We praise you. We give you the glory. We claim victory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Come on, everybody. Let's clap our hands and tell the Lord thank you. Oh, yes. Man sakes alive. Well, are we ready to do this thing again tonight? Amen. Last night we touched heaven. This morning was glorious, but tonight is going to be a new level and a new dimension. So get ready. I heard somebody say years ago, get ready, 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 get ready. Something good is going to happen in this place tonight. Amen. We thank you and appreciate all of you. There's an old country song. I think that urban boy from down in Australia, thank you. I think he done a song where the blacktop ends. Well, we welcome you out here in the country in Philadelphia where the blacktop ends. And we just going to do it old school tonight. Are y'all ready? We ain't got no carpet. We ain't got no ceiling in yet. But we're going to have ourselves some church up in here. I think Dr. Green christened the floor on last night. He danced all over this place. Amen. If you feel like dancing, you go ahead and dance. I may jump up and follow you here in a minute. Amen. But we're going to have a time. Dr. Martin is with us tonight. There's going to be a prophetic word in the house. Hallelujah. But most of all, King Jesus is here. And we welcome His Majesty. up in this place. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Praise God, praise God. I want to get started tonight. Before we do anything else, I want to ask Latasha if she'll come and sing tonight and bless us. It's good to have Tasha with us, and she's going to sing a song. Bless her heart. Amen. Everybody welcome her as she comes tonight. My oldest daughter, meanest daughter. And, we love her. I tell you what, they say that John Caleb is a mama's boy and that Latasha's a daddy's girl. And I think that that's true. Amen. And I meant to say something to somebody today about where we had all the flooring took up here. Somebody didn't nail it back down, but that's all right. Amen. It's Troy's fault. Amen. But anyhow, I think I'm big enough to hold it down from going anywhere tonight. Sister Dre, oh, wait a minute. Before you sing, let me tell you this. Sister Drennan, she told me last night we were sitting after service eating hot dogs. And out of everything that she could think to talk about while we're having a big hot dog dinner, and I'm just getting ready to eat a piece of that Boston cream cake, she starts talking about putting me on a diet. Amen. I told her, I said, okay, keep on talking, and while you're talking, cut me another piece of that cake. Amen. It's all in perspective, folks. It's all in perspective. How you look at it. Brother Merle, it's how you look at it. I'm telling you, my friend. Dr. Martin, I got one thing for you to take with you. A story I heard the other day. A friend of mine is an art dealer and said that he's worth about $8.5 million. And his lawyer called him and told him, I need you to come in and talk with you about important business. So he went to the lawyer's office. And the lawyer said, well, I got good news and I got bad news. Which do you want first? And that guy's like thinking, he's like, well, I had a bad day today, so give me the good news first to kind of cheer me up. He said, well, the good news is that your wife just bought two pictures today for $3,000. Said, but she thinks they're going to be worth about $4 million. He's like, yeah, that's the kind of news I've been needing to hear. He said, now what's the bad news? The lawyer looked at him and said, well, those pictures are of you and your secretary. Half of the marital assets, I'm just saying. Tasha's going to come and sing now. I quit. I'll leave all the bad jokes to Dr. Martin when he comes. So. Get it.
You can only come this far. And who showed the moon where to hide till the evening? Whose words alone can catch a falling star? Well, I the worn and the weak.
the Victory Temple for many years as a young child. We went all over the world. I mean, we went to Missouri, Michigan, anywhere you can think of almost as a child, I was too. You know, I think of the children today, they didn't want to go to school on their first day because they wanted to be right here this morning. I think about when I was a child, I missed two, three days to go on the road with him because I just knew in my heart that I wanted to go and serve the Lord. That hasn't changed one bit, folks.
Amen.
There's nowhere I would rather be on this one day than to sit right here in this convocation. And you know, that's all because he lives. You know, just thinking about, you know, going to church when I was young, mom, dad always went with me. Now there's a catch to this story. This is why I said this. He was talking about last night how he was never sent to church. I was never sent by them. They went with me all the time. But every time there was a church bus that came around this little hillside that I would like to go to, I'd put myself on a bus and go to church, come back, go to my church, and go to another one that night.
Yeah, praise God.
You know what it takes in this day and time? You've got to have dedication.
Yeah.
You know, I think of how it was as a child, having that dedication. And I know I'm not just talking about you, I'm talking about me. There's dedication issues that we all need to work on as individuals.
All right.
You know, you can come to church every Thursday night, you can go to church every Sunday night, you can go to church every time the door's open. But if your heart's not there, your mind's not set, you might as well stay home. Now tonight, I know Brother Martin, he's going to bring the word. And I know this altar's open anytime, just as it would be any other time.
Right.
Don't miss yours because you've got your mind here, you've got your mind there.
Right.
You're worried, you've got anything that you have on your mind, let it go.
Amen.
Right. If you leave it here tonight, you won't leave like you came, I swear.
Right.
You know, the Lord has never let me down. You know, we've came a long way.
Yeah.
You know, just thinking, last year at this time, we didn't have a
right.
We didn't have nowhere to go. You know, when our church burned to the ground, there wasn't one time that I can think of that anybody had a doubt that we were closing our doors.
Right, right.
It wasn't happening. That wasn't a thought.
Amen.
I can tell you for a fact, John Kettle was sitting at my house the night that he got the news, and he says, I got to go home. I got to get something done.
Amen.
For a teenager to say that, folks, we need to have dedication like
yes.
that.
Amen.
Now, for me, I'm going to open my ears, listen to what he has to say, fill up tonight from what we're going to receive and receive it. My challenge to you tonight is to open your ears, open your heart, and let it fill. That's all I got for y'all tonight.
Come on, give Tasha a great big cheer tonight. Amen. She's definitely a talker like her mama. I'm real quiet and backwards, don't have much to say. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Brother Troy, while you're up here, you might as well bless us with a song tonight, brother. Let me brag on Brother Troy for just a minute if I can. We've got a lot of folks that came to us for different reasons. I remember when Nanny Jeannie came to us. We talked about it last night. We had Betty Jean Robinson up at the church in Loudoun, and she came to hear Betty Jean sing. And she listened to Betty Jean sing and never left. And then Brother Troy came. I'll never forget it. We put our tent up in the park in Philadelphia over here. And Eric Henson. The original Hensons, The Lighthouse, Call Me Gone, all those great songs. We had Eric. Eric's a good friend of ours. He came in and sung, and Troy and Regina came, and we was needing somebody to help us with sound and music and lighting and cameras and all the stuff that Troy is so good at. And he told me, he said, when I walked in that church up there in Loudoun, I just knew I was home. And he's been with me ever since. And if I can lasso him and put a hitch around his neck wherever I go, I try to take him with me because he really knows how to lock and load with me. And when I minister and preach and here at the church, he's like a pocket on a shirt. He's just so handy. And we put so many responsibilities on him. But we appreciate Troy. And not only is he good on our sound and video and all those things, He's a wonderful singer and musician. Feels that if Caleb's away, Caleb thinks he's got to go off and do something different, which is rare. He goes out to Tasha sometimes, and that's about it. Troy fills in on the drums, fills in on the keyboards. I tell you, when Brother Copeland was here a few weeks ago, I was running late getting back from, I'm never late for church, folks, but I got hung in traffic and was running late, and I called and I said, I ain't going to be there at 7:30, it's on Thursday nights, I ain't going to be there at 7:30. They said, don't worry, Brother Troy's here, he's got it. And when I came in, they already had things kicked off and singing, music going. And I just felt like, you know, thank God. I didn't have to worry. But we're appreciative of Brother Troy and everything that he does. And we got this makeshift entrance out here. We actually put the little entrance up so we could haul wheelbarrows in. We tore all this flooring up, and we had to pour a lot of concrete under this building, and we was bringing wheelbarrows in, so we put that little walkway up, and we just kind of left it because it made it easier for folk to get in. And Troy said, you know, it's a big old hill down there, and he said, you know all these big women that come to church here.
Hey, I got to look out for the wife issue. I have to carry her back up.
Come on, I made all that up. But he was really concerned about somebody losing their balance and going down that hill. And exactly, here he come with a bunch of pallets.
Hey, they work for anything.
I seen on Facebook the other day, somebody made their living room furniture out of used pallets. I'm thinking, Sister Brennan told me the other day she wanted new furniture. And can you get more of them pallets?
Oh, sure. That's the fertilizer.
He's a golf course man. So, anyhow, he's going to bless us in song tonight. Will y'all say praise the Lord and welcome Brother Troy as he comes tonight.
Everybody's giving testimony. And, I've been looking forward to camp meeting for quite a few months now, you know, ever since we took the tent down. We had about a year. Y'all don't want to know where I come from, because that was the pits of hell itself. What Bishop tells you about the Hensons and stuff is true. Old Ronnie locked me up in the daggum bottom of the bus one time, and I'm thinking, man, they said something about Alabama. You know, black goes off when you close the door. You got a record. That was back in the day when they had vinyl. Yeah, not all of this little stuff. Memories of never trading anything. When I came to Word of Faith, I was homeless, I was jobless, I was carless, moneyless, everything. I was met with love, doors were open, and that's the way it's been ever since I've been around. I've seen some come, I've seen some go. But the memories of that place will never be. When we lost Sister Geneva, I'd get home first. Still bothers me. She was my prayer partner. Now Sister Miller is, she just don't know it yet. You were there for me through it all. When everyone around me said I would fall, you were my friend, and you believed in me. But through the good times, and through the bad, at times I felt like you, Lord, all I had. You were my friend, and you believed in me. You went the edge of mine to prove your love.
at your hand and be growing near you. When you could have walked away, turned your back to all. Yeah.
dead before you go. Just why you do. It's funny, just let it pass everywhere. I go, Jesus, he will be dead. Come on, sir, I'm in the bed. I am, I go, Jesus, he won't be dead for you. Yes, he knows just why that you do. Yeah.
Service tonight just a little bit. We are so grateful and thankful that you chose to come and be with us tonight. Let me jump up here for just a minute. Amen. I know Dr. Martin is probably going to sing, and if he don't, I know some folks will probably be upset. But I've known Woody Martin for over 30 years, and that's no joke. And everywhere that I've ever known him to go, he's always sung. Amen. And I think before he started preaching, he was already singing. We're just looking forward tonight to what he has to say to us. Not just what he has to say, but what the Holy Spirit has to say. Amen. And anyhow, we're just grateful that he chose to come. Now, I told him before he come, I said, our building is not anywhere near finished. And he said, well, I'm inviting myself to come preach anyhow.
Amen.
But he really did. That's no joke. He really did. And, of course, he knows he's always got an open invitation. He's been a friend. He's been a pastor. He's been a confidant. We share jokes with each other. I'm still trying to determine whose jokes are worse, mine or his. He asked me to preach here sometime back in Victory Temple, and I agreed I would do that, and I was more than honored to do so. And I thought, you know, Dr. Martin always throws in a few bad jokes. And so I went online, I went to Google, and I Googled bad jokes. And the response I got from Google was that there were none available. And so I began to do a little research, and I found out we traced the IP address back to Brother Martin's house. He had already took all of the bad jokes. We have such a me and David, his son David, we have such a good time because we already know when he's getting ready to start. David will be playing the drums, I'll be on the organ. I'll look at him, he'll look at me, and just kind of we'll nod because we know it's begun now. But all joking aside, for over 30 years, I've known this man, and we talked about this morning integrity. We talked, first of all, God. He's a man of integrity. If Jesus said it, it'll happen whether you believe it or not. He's a man of his word. One of the things that is missing in ministry today I mean, it's a sad day when they find pastors of mega churches dead in motels of heroin overdoses.
Amen.
It's an even sadder day when their wives, a year later, give an interview with Ebony Magazine and say that my husband didn't struggle with drug addiction. It was a lifestyle for him. It's a sad day. It says to me that we've lost integrity in the ministry. There's one thing I could say for Dr. Martin, and I've said that, Bishop Boswell, I've said this so many times right here. People will talk. Folks are going to say anything that they want to say. You can't keep people from talking. They'll tell all sorts of lies. Make stuff up. Just pull a story out of the hat and go and tell it about you. And you cannot help what people say about you. Nothing you can do about that. But you can be responsible to ensure that what they say is not true. They can call me a crook. It's up to me to make sure that I am not. They can call me a false prophet. It's up to me to make sure that I am not. They can say that I'm after people's money. It's up to me to make sure that I know in my soul, in my spirit, that I'm after people's hearts, that I'm trying to touch them with a word that will change their life. Let them talk, but in the end, integrity will always win. Come on, somebody. Integrity will always win. Now, I don't introduce all of our preachers in this fashion, but I've known Woody Martin for over 30 years, and I've known him personally. And I know that he is a man. He has a generous spirit. He has a generous heart. I said this in his church during his anniversary. All over Loudoun County, they talk about Woody Martin being the money preacher. He's after people's money. See, you've not seen the Woody Martin I've seen. You've not seen the Woody Martin that I've watched when he has known personally that someone was in financial straits. And off the camera.
Amen.
And off of the sight of the church, not in front of the church. Walk up to that sister or that brother. Put money that they needed in their hand to help them out of their trouble.
Hallelujah.
I probably shouldn't have said that around here, because now everybody will have a sad story tonight, hoping to get a little money. But but you didn't see, all you saw was the guy on television. All you saw was the guy in the pulpit. But I can tell you, I can testify to that. It's just like Jesus. Some folks know about the babe in Bethlehem. Some folks know about the man on the shore of Galilee. Some folks know about the carpenter's son and the one that taught in the temple. But I've had some personal experience with that man. And I can tell you a little bit more about him than just a babe in a manger. I can tell you just a little bit more than about a man on the shore of Galilee. I can tell you about somebody that said, I'll be your friend, and he has proven that he would never leave me, and that he would never forsake me, that he would always go with me. I can tell you more than about a teacher in the temple. I can tell you about somebody that has guided my life. And when the going got tough and I felt like throwing in the towel and giving up and quitting, he would come there and put his hand on my shoulder and tell me, hold on just a little bit longer, my son. You may be with your back against the wall right now, but in just a minute, I'm going to make a way where there seems to be no way. I'm going to open a door that no man can close, and close a door that no man can open, and I'm going to work that which seems to be impossible in your life. I'm going to make it a possibility. You can talk about a babe in a manger. You can talk
shores of Galilee. But I want to tell you about somebody that moved up in my house and has been with me every step of the way. And I know that he is a man of his word. Come on, somebody. You ought to get happy up in this house. I'm talking about a man of integrity.
Woo! That man, Jesus. Amen. I can assure you tonight, when this man of God steps into this pulpit, you're going to hear the voice of integrity.
Amen.
You're going to hear a prophetic word, a prophetic voice. I don't sing these songs about a lot of preachers. I'll talk about how that they can hoop and holler and scream and whatnot. But when you really know somebody, and you really appreciate them, you really respect them, and you really admire them. Here's what the Bible says, and I'm going to get out of the way so this preacher can preach, because I know he's jumping into bed. He's like myself. Here's what the Bible says about this kind of thing. Paul said, know them that labor among you, and he did not finish his thought there. I heard preachers preach on, you got to know people that labor among you. That's not where he finished the thought. He said, know those that labor among you and esteem them highly for their work's sake. And I have known this man, as I've said, for over 30 years. I've had the privilege to travel with him. I've had the privilege to work with him. I've had the privilege to be his organist, preach in his church. I even got a nice call from him today.
Amen.
Left me a nice little message wanting to know if I got saved last night. The good news is it happened, brother. Hallelujah. Amen. So he's going to get ready to come tonight. He's probably going to sing. I know he's going to preach. He may prophesy. He's going to obey God. And that's one thing I've learned about Brother Martin. If it's God, he's in it. If it's not, he's out. And one more thing, and I'm done. I've watched preachers that feel like that they're always on the spot, especially folks like Brother Martin and I operating the gifts or whatnot. We always feel like we're on the spot. People come, they want a word, they want a prophecy, we want to minister to them. We always feel like we're on the spot to perform. We've got to give folks what they want. But I've learned about Brother Martin, he's just like myself in this respect. If God ain't in it, he'll just keep his mouth shut, and better luck next time. Amen. I see what happens. Folks that feel like that they're obligated to move in those gifts when they're not functional, amen, that's when they miss.
Amen.
And you leave wreckage in the wake of your miss.
Amen.
So it's better not to say anything than to say something that you tell somebody God said when he didn't say it at all.
Amen.
If you go to the Old Testament warns us, woe unto the prophets that prophesy when I ain't spoken.
Right. Amen.
Amen. So we all have to be careful about that. So tonight, you can mark it down, my friend. If this man of God gives you a word, it's coming from the throne.
Amen.
And you can take it to the bank and cash it in for your promise, because it'll come to pass just like God said.
Amen.
So I'm going to ask everybody who would please stand to your feet one more time all over this little unfinished chapel tonight. And we're going to ask you if you would, amen, give your undivided attention to the man of God. We're going to ask you to take care of all your business early on. Get it out of the way. If you've got to go to the bathroom, whatever movement around you need to do, make sure that it's inspired by the Spirit tonight, because the Holy Ghost is going to move in this place, and we want to reverence God. So here he is, my friend, all the way from 14 miles up the road in Lenore City, Tennessee. Will you please make welcome our prophet, our pastor, Dr. Woody Martin, as he comes tonight.
Thank you, Bishop. Come on, let's give the Lord a clap of praise if you know Jesus tonight. Clap your hands all over the place and shout unto God. With the voice of triumph, not defeat, but triumph. Thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Somebody say, I got the victory. Amen. Through Jesus, I have the victory. By God, thank you for that introduction. I'll pay you after church.
Amen. You know, he got through. I just thank God for myself.
Oh, hallelujah. But we love Bishop and Sister Joyce. It's just a joy to be here tonight. We want to thank our congregation. We've got about five or six people. One, two, three, four, five, six people from our church, Victory Temple, represented here tonight. Seven people. Amen. Glory to God. We're glad. You know, that's one of the highest recommendations and the highest compliments you can pay your pastor.
Yes.
When you hear him preach every week, every week, every week, and then even when he goes out to a visiting church, you go and hear him preach. That's the highest compliment that you can make to a man of God. And when you do that to me, I try to preach myself to death. Amen. Glory to God. It's worse than sick them to a dog when you do me that way. Amen. Glory to God. We just thank God for being here. I got a word from the Lord. And you're not going to leave here like you came, in Jesus' name. Amen. You're not going to leave here like you came, in Jesus' name. We sang a song at the church. I remember years ago, my mother was a single parent, a widow, raising three children on $80 a month. And a man came to our door one day, and he knocked on the door, and he said, "Miss Martin," said, "I just want to know how you make it, raising these three kids and a very limited income." And she said, "It's just the blessings of the Lord. The Lord has been so good to me."
Oh, yes.
And I've told this several times, but I'm going to say it right quickly. I saw a man had a silver dollar one time.
Amen.
And that's the prettiest thing I've ever seen in my life. A new silver dollar just shining like new money, because that's what it was, new money. And I asked Mama, I said, "Mama, can you give me a silver dollar?" She said, "Son, I don't have no money to get a silver dollar, but if you'll pray, God will give you one."
All right.
I was about 8 or 9 years old. So I prayed. And this man came to our house, had a bag of groceries under each arm, and he kicked on the door. Could not knock on it. He kicked on the door, old screen door. Mama went to the door, and he gave Mama those groceries, and she thanked him and prayed with him. And he said, "How do you make it? Just a small income, these three kids." She said, "It's the blessings of the Lord. Lord, 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 you've been so good to me." But anyway, she brings the groceries in there, and there was a gallon of ice cream in there. And I had my peanut butter sandwich for my supper, and I asked Mama if I could have some of that ice cream. She said, "Yes, I'm going to get it." I got me a big old spoon, and I started digging in that gallon of ice cream, and I heard metal hitting metal. That spoon in that ice cream, thought, "What's going on here?" And I got to digging around, I finally dug it up, and I looked at it, and I licked it. Turned around, I licked it again. And then I looked at it, and I looked at it, and I took it over to the kitchen sink, and I washed it off, and it was a brand new silver dollar. Then I understand the old saying, cold cash. Amen. But she told me to pray, and I prayed, and I think that the first time that God ever heard my prayer.
All right.
Yeah. And I'm thankful my mother birthed that in me. Yeah. My heritage is to believe God.
All right.
And when that man left, my mother would say, "Oh, Lord, 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 you've been so good to me. Lord, 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 you've been so good to me. Lord, 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 you've been so good to me. Well, you've done what no other man could do." Sing the song. I said, "Lord, Lord, Lord, I was hungry.